The next activity that we have is performing point-in-time recovery with incremental backups. The best part about this activity is most of the environments will have incremental backups, right? Not many will prefer to go for DB full backups. The activity is same, but let's take we have level 0 backup. We will create a new user. We will take L1 backup, and then we simulate a failure that we have lost the data files. Now we want to recover the database before this user was created. We assume these are wrong transactions and we want to open the database just before this transaction happened, right? So what we will do is we'll restore from the L0 backup, because restore can be done only from L0 backup, not from L1 backup. And then we will recover from this L1 backup, but it will be a point-in-time recovery. So we will apply L1 backup till this time before this user is created, and then we open the database. We are not performing complete recovery till here. Now after we open the database, we must not be able to see this user. So this user should not be visible. Let us perform this activity. Okay. Let us take a backup level 0. RMAN target slash catalog RMAN RC RMAN RC at the rate RCAT. Now we are taking a level 0 backup of the database. As I said, before every activity, it's good to take a backup. Okay, great. So backup is completed. We can check the backup tag via this command. So this is our L0 backup that we have just now taken. Just copy this backup tag for our reference. Let us connect to SQL Plus. We'll first check the date and time, because this is the date and time till which we'll perform the recovery. I'm just making a note of it. Now we'll create a new user OGR1 and then grant the required permissions to the user. Now connect with the user and create a test table. So we are assuming these transactions are wrong transactions, and we will perform a point-in-time recovery before this transaction. Now commit just to make sure transactions are all saved. Select star from test. So we have this table, right? I'll connect back as sysdba. Now we'll trigger the level 1 backup right now. Exit. So RMAN target slash. We are now taking the backup incremental level 1 database plus archive log. Enter. Now we are taking both again level 1 database plus archive log backup. Okay, our L1 backup has also been completed. Let us check the backup tag. So for this L1 backup, this is the backup tag. Just make a note of this backup tag. Now we'll have to simulate a failure. Delete all the data files from the server. So we'll exit from RMAN, SQL plus slash sysdba. Now select name from v$data file. These are all the data files. What I'll do is I'll just remove these data files. Remember, our database instance is running. We are just trying to simulate a failure, right? We'll start the recovery, kill the database instance if it is already running. So we have ps-af grep pmon. So kill-9, this is the process ID for proddb. The instance has been killed. Once again, check whether it is cleared or not. Done. Now start the database instance and take it to mount stage. Because we have SP file and control files, we can take our database till mount stage, right? Okay. Whenever you kill the instance, it takes some time for database instance to shut down. So just wait for some time. Now you can see it has connected to idle instance. Even though if it is connected like this, still if you issue any transactions, it won't work. But still make sure you see this line connected to idle instance. Now we can start the database instance and take it to mount stage. Startup, mount. Great, database has been mounted. Now we have to connect to RMAN and issue below command. First of all, because we are performing point-in-time recovery, we will set the time, set until time, and we have to give the time in this command. So we have the time before these transactions were issued. Just copy this one and paste it over here. Right? Next is restore database. We can restore only from level 0 tag, correct? So RMAN target slash yeah. List backup of database summary. This is the L0 tag, correct? So I can restore only from this L0 tag. So just get this tag and put it over there. Now we can perform the database recovery from L1 tag. This is the L1 tag. By looking at the recovery process, we are applying this L1 tag and we are telling that only apply till this time before this user was created. And that's why we have set until time clause over here on the top. Even though we are saying recover database from the tag, so this tag or this L1 will be applied only till this time. So all the transactions after this time will not be applied to the database. So don't worry. And then alter database open reset logs. Why reset logs? Because this is an incomplete recovery. So we'll run this block. Now with our L0 tag, all the data files are being restored to their original locations. Great. So now we can see, because we don't have so many transactions, so many archive logs, so many log switches, we can see that it has applied some transactions from the archive logs, right? So it might have taken these archive logs and there are few transactions in those archive logs that is it has applied. But as per our recovery scenario, right now we have opened our database over here. So we should not see this new user, okay? So don't worry, because we don't have much transactions. That's why RMAN has applied archives on the disk. But we'll exit. So SQL plus slash SSDBA. So select name comma open underscore mode from v$database. And now we should not see the newly created user. So connect OGR1 as OGR1. We can see invalid user ID and password. That means we have exactly recovered our database before these wrong transactions happened inside the database. So this is how we perform database point-in-time recovery via RMAN incremental backups.